فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، واشهد ان سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى اله واصحابه والتابعين لهم باحسان الى يوم الدين، اما بعد. ان شاء الله تعالى، normally today on Sunday we have the sharh of the kitab حلية طالب العلم by Sheikh Bakr ibn Abdullah Abu Zayd رحمه الله تعالى. But because Ramadan has finished and we have finished Ramadan, it will be beneficial inshallah ta'ala to take a reminder, because the reminder benefits the believer. And a lot of the times what you see is that people, they make their habit, what they normally do habitually, what they do is wherever they go they make it into lectures and muhadarat and reminders are for people who are studying, for people who have a routine where they are nurturing themselves with knowledge. Then sometimes their aspiration dies, a reminder is given, it boosts it up again. Just like a person can't live on paracetamol or Panadol, they have food, sometimes they get sick, they take paracetamol. Then the muhadara is like a paracetamol. When a person is a bit sick, they feel like their hard work has now become, a reminder is given to them. But to always make it into a muhadara, it doesn't benefit, in the sense when the person walks away, there's nothing after that. They have nothing to carry themselves on. So it's very important that learning and studying is given precedence. Brothers and sisters who are listening, Ramadan has finished and a lot of us was working very, very hard. We put a lot of effort in this great month of Ramadan. We were fasting, and at night time we were praying and we were reading Quran. We made it a month where we got closer to Allah highly. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abu Huraira, other different companions narrated it. The Prophet said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna li kulli amalin shirah. Every action that a person does, they're working hard towards, there's a period where the person just starts to go down after hard work. إِنَّ لِكُلِّ عَمَلٍ شِرَةٍ وَلِكُلِّ شِرَةٍ فَتْرَةٍ فَمَنْ كَانَتْ فَتْرَةُ إِلَى سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَى وَمَنْ كَانَ إِلَى غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, every action, there's a time when it has a downfall, where this person starts to go less and starts to reduce. Pay attention. This is what happened to so many people, or is happening to so many people. Ramadan, they reached the top pinnacle that they could reach. But then after that, they started to go down. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in this hadith, anyone who that time when he goes down, he's still in accordance to the sunnah, then he's guided. And anyone who goes down and he was upon misguidance, then he's misguided. He was on innovation, he's misguided. This hadith shows that we're bound as human beings to go up and to come down, to go up and to come down. It's going to happen regardless. But then we need to know what is it that allows us to try to get up again and make it back to where we were. As a human, you're bound to fall and you're bound to trip. But how can you stand up again and go back to what you were doing? Brothers, in this month of Ramadan, the thing that we were working on, or the thing that was making us move, the thing that we were using was our heart. It was the qalb. And after Ramadan, it is the heart that is needed to be worked on. Wallahi, brothers, you see a person who spends so many hours in the gym. Very strong person, tough, big. Very big. And he struggles fajr to get out of the bed, to lift the duvet and just leave and go to the masjid. Where is the strength on the body? Where's the... This man's picking a 19 kg on this side, another guy... The metal bar has bended. It's how heavy it is. But for fajr, he can't lift this soft cotton. He can't. Why? This shows you that the body only brings out what's in the heart. And if the person succeeds and so is successful in working on this heart, this body might look very deficient. It might look very weak. It might not be able to do it. But trust me, this person goes very far. And that is why we need to focus in this time that Ramadan has gone, this heart of ours. And we have to nurture it. The heart suffers from two illnesses, brothers. And these two illnesses, Ramadan, a believer was fighting against it. It was ash-shubha wa shahawat. Desires, then we were fasting. And fasting is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which he said, Ya ma'ashara ash-shabab, youngsters, youth, man istata'a minkumul ba'ata falyatazawwaj. Any one of you who is able to get married, then get married. Wa man lam yastati', and those who are not able, fa'alayhi bis-sawm, fast. Why? Because fasting, fa'innahu yakunu alayhi wija. The fasting will be for him, ama what? The fasting is what? Huh? It's bigger than a shield. The word wija' has a bigger meaning. A wija' is to castrate an animal. It can't have no sexual desires anymore. It's taking the vein that runs in the animal's testicle to never ever desire a woman. Fasting will do that to you. It's not just a shield. Even fasting destroys the shahwa fully. You see? So, shahwa in the month of Ramadan, we were fighting against it. Ramadan is gone, we fought against it. What's left now? Shubha. Mutaba'at al-Rasul. We were fasting the times that we were sent. The sunnah of how the Prophet ﷺ fasted. From the time to the time that we need to fast. Then we were in a time where we were taught, stay away from shubuhat and shahawat. If Ramadan leaves and if you fall into shortness in any of those two, it causes illness to the heart. And brothers, the status and the sha'an, the affairs of the heart, is very great. The first one is al-qalbu huwa mahallu niyat. The heart, intention springs from the heart. The heart is the where the intention springs from. إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته لدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة يتزوجها أما ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. It's the heart. The thing that your prayer is accepted without it, your salah is not accepted, is basically something that comes from the heart. Isn't that great? The second thing is al-qalbu huwa mahallu al-Qur'an. The Qur'an, the place where Allah told us that He keeps it in and it's kept in, is the heart. He said in the Qur'an, وَإِنَّهُ, this dhamir goes back to the Qur'an, أي القرآن, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنْذِرِينَ بِلِسَانِ الْعَرَبِيِّ مُبِينَ. The Qur'an, the place where it resides, it stays in, Allah says, is the heart. وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. Muhammad, I sent the Qur'an on your heart. And لذلك, when the Prophet tried to speak the Qur'an and tried to read it, Allah said to him, لَا تُحَرِّكْ بِهِ لِسَانَكَ لِتَعْجَلَ بِهِ. Don't move your tongue fast so you can read the Qur'an with us. Don't do that. Just let it go into your heart directly. That's where it's going to be kept. إِذَا مَحَلُّ, where is the Qur'an kept? It's the heart. That's where it stays in. لذلك الله says in another ayah, بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. The Qur'an is verses that is kept in the chest of the people of knowledge. لذلك some of the ulama, they said, مَنْ حَفِظَ الْقُرْآنَ فَهُوَ عَالِمٌ. Anyone who memorized the Qur'an is a scholar, is an alim. Because Allah said in this ayah, بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. Allah said the scholars. So the Qur'an, the place where it stays in is what? The heart. ولذلك, that's why whenever the person does not ponder on the Qur'an, there's a deficiency in the heart. And why is there a deficiency in the heart, brothers? It's because that's where it resides. How can the heart not ponder on it? أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. That's what Allah says. Do they not ponder on the Qur'an, or are there locks on their hearts? Because the Qur'an is there. So how is it that you can't ponder on it? فَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Or are there locks on their heart? The third one is الْقَلْبُ هُوَ مَحَلُّ نَظَرِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. The heart is what Allah looks at. It's what Allah observes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لذلك the hadith Imam Muslim من حديث أبي هريرة إن الله لا ينظر إلى أجسامكم ولا إلى صوركم. Allah does not look at your physique. Allah does not look at your body and how big you are. Doesn't look at that. ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم. Allah looks at your actions and He also looks at your heart. So Allah تبارك وتعالى is observing your heart and what then your heart produces. Because the قاعدة is وكل إناء بالذي فيه ينضح. Every vessel only sweats what's inside it. You'll only bring out from your limbs what your body has sweat out. If I want to know that a cup is cold or hot, I don't need to put my finger in it. I can know it from outside. So the heart, if it's good, we can know it from your limbs. If we want to know what's inside, if it's good, we can know it from your limbs and the way you act and the way you are. So Allah looks at it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. إخواني القلب, the heart, هو محل التقوى. Taqwa, that's where it is. That's where it resides. A person who's got taqwa, and then piety, taqwa is piety. It's the heart. Based on the hadith in Sahih Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, At-taqwa hahuna, at-taqwa hahuna, at-taqwa hahuna, wa ashara ila sadri thalatha marrat. And the Prophet pointed towards his chest 3 times. My brothers, Nabiullah Ibrahim made a dua, supplication to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And he said to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, وَلَا تُخْزِنِ يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. Allah تبارك وتعالى, do not humiliate me and do not harm me the day of judgment. صح؟ What day لكن؟ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Allah, don't humiliate me that day, the day of judgment, the day where children and money are not going to benefit you. The only thing that's going to benefit you is the person who comes to Allah with a what? A qalb which is salim. A qalb which is clean and pure. And we said the word salim here, brothers, means what? It means salimun min ash-shubuhati wash-shahawat. It is pure from whims and desires, and it's also pure from doubts. It's a heart that's protected. The person who wants, my brothers, to find happiness, who wants to find tranquility, who wants to find ease and smoothness in life, there's no other part of his body that he needs to look at other than his heart. In the month of Ramadan, I read the Quran. I looked at which the Quran, many times I read it. And when I came across every organ that was mentioned in the Quran, I would take a note of it. I realized that the organ that was mentioned the most in the Quran, more than 130 times above, after 130 I gave up. It's 130 and above times, either directly or indirectly, was what? The heart. Either Allah said it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the qalb itself by name, or He spoke about the things that the qalb does and the actions that it stands for and what it represents. You open the Mus'haf today, you read Surah Al-Fatiha, then you move on to Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah that you read, He mentioned 3 characteristics straight away. Allah mentioned 3 asnaf, 3 types of people. Pay attention, Surah Al-Baqarah. All of us here, we read Surah Al-Baqarah. The first thing Allah opens Surah Al-Baqarah is with what? Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدَى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This Quran, there's no doubt in it. Doubt comes from where? The heart. Straight away you're being told, straight after Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ. This is the book. There is no doubt in it. So there shouldn't be no doubt in your heart. Straight away your heart is being spoken to. Then it's amazing because Allah mentioned 3 asnaf and 3 people. 3 characteristics are mentioned in that first safha, the first page, which is the first characteristics of what? ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى مُتَّقِينَ. We just took taqwa. Where's taqwa? Hadith Sahih Muslim. التقوى ها هنا التقوى ها هنا التقوى ها هنا وأشار إلى صدره 3 مرات عليه الصلاة والسلام. The second characteristics were what? مؤمنين. The أصل of إيمان is where? القلب. الثاني والوزوات موقنين. People have certainty. Where does that characteristic come from? Then after that Allah says, إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون ختم الله قلوبهم. These are the kuffar. This is the second type of people in Surah Al-Baqarah. And then Allah moves on to the third type of people, and who are the munafiqeen. ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين يخادعون الله والذين آمنوا وما يخدعون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون في قلوبهم في قلوبهم. So the two other parties are being cancelled out because of their hearts. And the first party of the people are the believers. Their reason was because they made sure their hearts had taqwa, it had iman, and it had yaqeen. Are you with me, brothers? ولذلك, anyone who wants to advise a person or who wants to benefit a person, the first thing he needs to tell a person to work on is the heart, first of all. Because this, if he succeeds in making sure that he advises a person to work on his heart, then that is what's going to control everything else. And we clearly have that from the Prophet. إن الحلال بين وإن الحرام بين وبينهما أمور مشتبهات لا يعلمهن كثير من الناس فمن اتقى الشبهات فقد استبرأ لديني وعرضي ومن وقع في الشبهات وقع في الحرام كالراعي يرعى حول الحمى يوشك أن يرتع فيه ألا وإن لكل ملك حمى ألا وإن حمى الله محارمه ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسد فسد الجسد كله ألا وهي القلب. So it's the organ that the Prophet is saying here, that if this organ is in good shape and it's healthy, then every part of your body is healthy. And if this organ is diseased and it's going through a hard time, then all of your body is going to be going through a hard time. And this is what Allah said in an ayah. الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Remembering Allah, does the heart find tranquility? So you see, Qiyamul Layl was being done in Ramadan. The person was reading the Quran. The person was fasting. They were nurturing this heart very well. Shayateen were locked off. You had that opportunity to just face yourself with Allah and work hard. Ramadan has now gone. You've gone back to exactly what you were doing. The reason is because of there's a deficiency in that heart. So you need to make sure that you work on it. My brothers, the Prophet is with his companions in the battle of Tabuk. Brothers, Tabuk, the Prophet spent there 6 months, alayhi salatu wasalam, 6 months. 6 months. Tabuk to Medina is a distance of 1,400 kilometers, approximately. Makkah to Medina is 400. 1,400 something. It was the hottest battle that the companions participated. The heat was so severe that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said to the companions, the companions, قُلْ نَارُ جَهَنَّمَ أَشَدُّ حَرًّا لَوْ كَانُوا يَفْقَهُونَ. That, among the munafiqeen, that the heat of the hellfire is greater than this heat that you guys are looking at. This is nothing compared to Jahannam. So work hard. That battle of Tabuk, the Prophet is with his companions. And as he's with his companions, he said to his companion, Hadith of Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, which is a Sahih Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ لَرِجَالًا ما سرتم مسيرا ولا قطعتم واديا الا كانوا معكم وفي روايه حبسوهم العذر and another riwayah الا شاركوكم في الاجر. You guys have not cut a distance, you have not cut a valley, you have not taken a step except they participated with you in reward. Some brothers of yours in Medina, they have not walked with you guys, they're not with you guys, they're not traveling, they're not moving around. Whatever 1,000 and something kilometers you guys have cut, they're in Medina and they have the reward with you guys. They participate with this reward with you. Why? Allah mentions their story in the battle in Surah At-Tawbah. ليس على الضعفاء ولا على المرضى ولا على الذين إذا ما أتوك لتحملهم قلت لا أجد ما أحملهم تولوا وأعينهم تفيض من الدمع حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. They came to the Prophet. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they came to the Prophet, what did they request from him? They said, Ya Rasulullah, take us with you. The Prophet didn't have the money to take him, to take them with him. And they started to cry and they turned away crying. They wanted to come from their heart. They were crying, Ya Rasulullah, don't leave us. Please take us with you. Wallahi, we want to participate in this expedition with you. Wallahi, Ya Rasulullah, we want to be with you in it. But because they didn't get that, but the heart wanted it, The heart wants it. The limbs doesn't have to do it if the heart is there. ولذلك, the woman who goes through her menstruation, she goes through her period. If she used to fast on Mondays and Thursdays and her menstruation hits on Monday, she gets the reward of that fasting. Because of her intention. The qiyam that she used to do, she gets it. She's like the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. She gets the reward, أجر المقيم. The person, if a traveler was traveling and he stopped some things that he used to do while he was a resident, now because he's traveling, he can't do it. He gets the reward of those things. Why is he getting the reward for it? He hasn't done it. Hasn't worked for it. It's the qalb, my brothers, the heart. So if you make sure that your heart is that clean and that good, even if you don't do the issue, you get it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to them, and this is something, my brothers, that we need to do. Sometimes, even that we now realize the value and the strength and the power of the heart, these are things, wallahi, we can do, and they are going to help us a lot. And that is the remembrance of Allah. You pray Salatul Fajr, you pray Fajr, you say Salamu Alaikum, Salamu Alaikum, don't move from your position. Sit there and do dua, adhkar, until the sun rises. Sit there and just do it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the companions one day, أَلَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ, shall I not tell you, بِخَيْرِ أَعْمَالِكُمْ, the best of your actions. Brothers, pay attention. The word Arabic, in the Arabic language, when you see the word khair, صِغَةُ الْمُبَالَغَةِ, it comes in the form of أَفْعَل. صِغَةُ الْمُبَالَغَةِ. Or, like you would say, فُلَان أَطْوَلُ مِنْ فُلَان, so-and-so is taller than فُلَان. But because of the use of the word khair so much, and the word shar so much, بِكَثْرَةِ اسْتِعْمَالِهَا سُقِطَةِ الْأَلِفِ, Alif was dropped. So here it's meant to be akhyar, the greatest. Huh? In English they call it superlative. Superlative. There you go. Waqas. It's a superlative. Ala unabikum, shall I tell you, bi khayri a'malikum, the best of actions which you guys could do. Wa azkaha 'inda malikikum, and it's most purifying to your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَرْفَعُهَا فِي دَرَجَاتِكُمْ, and it's the greatest thing that will lift you in statuses and in rank. وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, and it's better for you. مِنْ إِنْفَاقِ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ, and it's also even better in giving gold and silver. For you to go out and give gold and silver every day, charity. For you to do that, this is better. وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, and this is even better. مِنْ أَنْ تَلْقَوْ عَدُوَكُمْ فَتَضْرِبُوا أَعْنَاقَهُمْ وَيَضْرِبُوا أَعْنَاقَكُمْ. That you go to a battlefield and you fight with your enemies, you strike their necks and they strike your neck. Shall I tell you something better than all of that? The companions, of course. This is what they lived for. This is what they won. For them, it meant a pitch. Yeah. Haha. They didn't say na'am. Look how powerful the companions were. They didn't say yes. They said bala, of course. They really want to know. And this is going to be something, as soon as it comes out from the Prophet's mouth, that it's going to be implemented. It won't go anywhere else. It will go into their actions. What did the Prophet say to them? Dhikrullah ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah. And Imam al-Tirmidhi, Imam Malik, Ibn Majah, and Ahmed narrated this hadith. So, sitting down, وَلِذَلِكَ Ibn al-Qayyim, Ibn al-Qayyim. When you think of Ibn al-Qayyim, what do you think of straight away? The heart, right? Ibn al-Qayyim, the heart. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he said, I came to Ibn Taymiyyah one day, and I saw him sitting down, and he was doing his adhkar. Sometimes even people just look at Ibn Taymiyyah as a warrior, writer, jay, the refuter. People don't realize what he does behind closed doors and the way he was, where he lifted his actions up and he purified himself. Alayhi rahmatullah. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah would sit down and he would do his adhkar and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim said, I saw him and he turned around and looked at me. He said to me, this is my breakfast. Ibn al-Qayyim, this is my breakfast. If I don't do it, I am not energized for anything. And I don't have the effort, strength to do anything. You know, if you don't eat breakfast in the morning, you're tired, you can't do nothing. If I don't do my adhkar, I am... Sah? So the reality is, وَلِذَلْكَ Ibn al-Qayyim said, إِذَا سَأَتْ بِنَا الظُّنُونَ, if thoughts were bad to us, and you know, we went through hardship, and غَمْ and هَمْ, and depression and sadness, would come to Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn al-Qayyim would go to Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn al-Qayyim, the book I have here is called Ighathatul Lahfan fi Masayid al-Shaytan. I'm probably reading it right now. which I'm going to mention some of things of it, inshallah, some quotes from it, which is basically the heart. Abdul Razzaq Al-Afifi, rahimahullah. Abdul Razzaq Al-Afifi, you guys know him? So Abdul Razzaq Al-Afifi was the naib, he was after Ibn Baz. Abdul Aziz Ibn Baz, when he would go, Abdul Razzaq Al-Afifi would be the mufti for that prophet. He was the naib, he was right after him. Abdul Razzaq Al-Afifi said about Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah Ibn Al-Qayyim, he said, Ibn Taymiyyah is like he headbutts the mountain. And he breaks it. Ibn Al-Qayyim comes and he collects them. And that's how it was. Whatever Ibn Taymiyyah said, there were ambiguity in it. Ibn Al-Qayyim, he broke it down and explained it. So Ibn Al-Qayyim is now going to his teacher and finding this. And this is what's needed, brothers. Dhikrullahi, the remembrance of Allah. Also, my brothers, the other thing that we need to do is, that we need to strive to is, that we go to places of funerals and the places where qubur, visit the dead. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Kuntu nahaytukum an ziyarati al-quburi fazuruha." I used to prohibit you from going to visit the graves. Now go and visit it. Fa innaha, verily, the death reminds you what? Turiqul qalb. There's a riwayah that says it softens the heart. Wa tadma'u al-ayn, and it makes the eyes water. وَتُذَكِّرُ الْآخِرَةِ It will remind you of the hereafter. And Imam al-Hakim al-Bayhaqi narrated it. Bayhaqi narrated in Shu'ab al-Iman. And Ahmad in his Musnad. So my brothers, these are things that we need to do towards our hearts. Make sure that we work towards it. We nurture it. We come with the things that the heart needs. The same way that your body needs food in order to live, the heart needs it. But that is some of the Salaf used to say, وَرُبَّ مُبَيِّضٌ ثِيَابَهُ There's maybe a person who's walking around and he's got a white garment, very clean. He looks after his outer appearance. Like in the مُدَنِّسٌ فِي دِينِهِ But his religion, he's tainted it. He's tainted his religion. He does not care about his heart. How dirty and how... لذلك the poet, he said, رَأَيْتُ الذُّنُوبَ تُمِيتُ الْقُلُوبَ I saw that the sins, they kill the hearts. The heart, the sin that a person commits will go directly towards the heart and it will affect the heart until the person reaches a point where there's nothing which they can do in order to gain the remembrance of Allah. Also, my brothers, what we need to do is make dua and supplicate and ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala as the Prophet used to do. He used to say, Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub. I have not come across any other limb that the Prophet specifically used to ask dua for. He used to say, Ya muqallib al-qulub. ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِي عَلَى دِينِكَ Oh Allah, the one that tosses and turns the hearts. Make my heart steadfast and firm on your religion. And Imam al-Tirmidhi Ahmad and Hakim al-Tabarani narrated it. Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, he said to her one day, Ya Umm Salama, the Prophet said this to her, إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ آدَمِيٌّ There's no human being. إِلَّا وَقَلْبُ بَيْنَ أُصْبُعَيْنِ مِنْ أَصَابِعِ الرَّحْمَنِ Except that his heart is between the two fingers of Allah. There is no human except that his heart is between the two fingers of Allah. فَمَنْ شَاءَ قَامًا Whoever Allah wills, he makes his heart steadfast. وَمَنْ شَاءَ زَاغًا And whoever Allah wills, he diverts him and destroys him. Tirmidhi and Ahmed and Tabarani narrated it and Abu Bakr ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf. Brothers, the human nature, as the way Allah created us, there are two characteristics we were created with. And every day of our lives, every day we walk, we're working towards removing these two characteristics. This morning when I woke up, my ambition, I was asked, what's your main goal today? My main goal was to always get rid of these two characteristics that Allah created me in. And these are the characteristics which Allah mentions in the ayah, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we presented the amana to the samawat. The amana, it means Allah came to the samawat and he said, here's the amana, can you take it? وَالْجِبَال and the mountains. And the earth, all of them, they rejected it. They said, we can't take it. فَأَبَيْنَا أَن يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقَنَا مِنْهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ But the human, he said, I'm going to take that. And I'm going to carry it. The mountain said, no. The samawat said no. The earth said no. But the human said yes. Pay attention to the ayah, because the ayah needs pondering and it needs us to analyze it. Tadabbur. This amana that we chose to take, the way that the people take the amana are three types. The first people are those who they agree to the amana, which was tawheed. Alastu bi rabbikum qalu bala. The amana here is the tawheed. It is to take Allah tabarak wa ta'ala as our Lord and worship Him alone. The people are three in it. Those who have rejected it qalban wa qaliban, from the heart and externally as well, and internally, both, they've rejected it. They don't do it from the outer, and they do it from outside. And these are the kuffar. The second are the munafiqeen. They don't do it from the outer, but they do it, they don't do it from the inner, but they do it from the outer. They would fight with the Muslims, and they would be with the Muslims, they would pray with the Muslims. But from the heart, they don't accept the amana. And the third party are those who've accepted it. قَلْبًا وَقَالِبًا, externally and internally. But it's amazing, after Allah mentions the amana in the ayah, He mentions two characteristics. He says about the human, إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا, that the human is ignorant. صِغَةُ الْمُبَالَغَةَ, فُعُول. The human is excessively ignorant and excessively oppressive. The Mufassirin, they say, كَبْنُ الْقَيِّمَ غَيْرُهُ, they said that due to these characteristics, the person suffers in amana. It is because either ignorance or it's oppression or both together. However much your ignorance is high and your oppression is high, is how much you are in terms of holding the amana that was given to you. The opposite, brothers, as I was reading the Quran in the month of Ramadan, I came across the ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says on the tongue of Nabiullah Ibrahim, رَبَّنَا وَبَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He brought which first? Which characteristics that Allah mentioned? رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابِ. In surah, in another place, Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, هُوَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِمْ. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب. This one. ربنا وابعث فيهم is not ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب. أي ويزكيهم is ويعلمهم الكتاب ويزكيهم. The علم comes before the تزكية. In the one Nabiullah Ibrahim when he makes a dua. And in this ayah, the تزكية comes before the علم. In one place, the علم comes before the تزكية. And in one place, the tazkiyah comes first before the ilm. And Allah doesn't do anything except He does it with a sabab, a reason behind it. So why is it that Allah put here the knowledge before the tazkiyah, and another place He put the tazkiyah before the knowledge? The ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab, which I read, is the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did it. One is talking about the human's essence. إِنَّوْ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. That Nabiullah Ibrahim, when he asked, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Nabiullah Ibrahim's dua, he's talking about the essence of the human being. A prophet that cures them from the essence of what they are. Why would he? Because he put knowledge first. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Nabiullah Ibrahim is talking about the essence of the human. And the other ayah is referring to after the human has nurtured himself from it. ولذلك, the thing that we need to understand is, إِنَّوْ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. What is the solution for an ignorance? Huh? And what is the solution for an oppression? تَزْكِيَة. Are you with me? Knowledge. ولذلك, that's why the Prophet was sent. He was sent, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ. He teaches them the kitab. وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ, and He purifies them. That is the job of the Prophet. The scholars, they questioned one another. Ibn al-Qayyim in his Kitab Bada'i al-Fawaid, he says that, what is the minimum that a person has to have in terms of knowledge, and what is the minimum that a person has to have from tazkiyah? The minimum that a person needs to have from knowledge is al-yaqeen, certainty. And the minimum that a person needs to have from tazkiyah is sabr. If a person has yaqeen and sabr, what does he get? What does he reach? وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. When a people, they come with patience and they come with certainty, Allah makes them what? He makes them leaders. He makes them what? وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ, we made them leaders. Banu Israel. When did we make them leaders? لَمَّا صَبَرُوا, when they were patient. وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ, and they came with certainty. So a believer, every day he wakes up, he's working towards these two. He's working towards what? الصبر واليقين. لذلك ابن تيمية said, بالصبر واليقين تنال الإمامة في الدين. With patience and certainty, the person would reach what? Leadership. And so that makes us, brothers, understand to always, every day we wake up, to make dua, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make dua. He used to say, salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi, Allahumma habib ilayna al-iman, wa zayyinhu fi qulubina, wa karrih ilayna al-kufra wal-fusuqa wal-isyan, wa ja'alna min al-rashideen. The Prophet used to make that dua, and this was ma'khudhu min qawlihi ta'ala, it was taken from the statement of Allah, walakinna Allah habbaba ilaykum al-imana, wa zayyinahu fi qulubikum, وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصْيَانِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الرَّاشِدُونَ. It's taken from that ayah. Finally, my brothers, we also need to be those who recite the Qur'an a lot and stay away from music that will cause the illness of the heart. ولذلك, that's why Allah said in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ. O people, it has come to you, مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ, a reminder from your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ, and a cure to the heart. This Qur'an is a cure to the heart. وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ, and it's a guidance and a mercy for the believers. So the Qur'an is the cure for the heart. Allah said about the believers, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, they are those who are the believers. إذا ذكر إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentions their hearts, they find, they tremble their hearts. Their hearts tremble from the recitation of the Quran. الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثاليا تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. In Surah Al-Hadid, he says, ألم يأني للذين آمنوا أن تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله وما نزل من الحق ولا يكون كالذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبل فطال عليهم الأمد فقست قلوبهم وكثير منهم فاسقون. And the Quran is what affects the people's hearts, to increase in the recitation of the Quran, and also, brothers, to just sit down and focus on this book and to ponder and to analyze it. You might read the Quran a lot sometimes and think to yourself, I've understood it, mashallah, I understand this. It's amazing because recently I was in Umrah and in Ramadan, and I was in the Haram, and I was reading the kitab written by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqit rahimahullah, which is the kitab Rihlati ila Afriqiya, my journey to Africa. Sheikh Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqit has a rihla of when he went to Africa. So while I was reading it, he was speaking about dalalatul iqtida', which is issue of usul al-fiqh. But ala kulli hal, there's a story that the ulama mentioned. Ibn Kathir brings it in the ayah, وَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهًا وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ ثَلَاثُونَ شَهْرًا. It brings it in the ayah. Suratu Al-Ahqaf, third page. So he mentions a story Ibn Abd al-Barr brings this story in his Kitab al-Tamhid, but he brings it in the story of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He mentions it, Umar with Ali. But the story, the correct version of it, even Abd al-Barr brings the other version of it, which is, it is Ali ibn Abi Talib and Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. At the time of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, a woman, she got married to a man. And when she got married to this man, when she got married to this individual, after 6 months she gave birth. After 6 months, she gave birth. So the husband goes, this is not my child. It was brought to Uthman. Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, okay, 6 months, stone her. She was taken out. The story reached Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ali hastened. And he went to Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. What did he say to Uthman when he went to him? He said to Uthman, have you not read the Quran? Ali said to who? Have you not read the Quran? Brothers, do you guys know Uthman's level in the Quran? And his caliber of the Quran? Uthman said, nah, I read the Quran. What is it that you're referring to? And Ali ibn Abi Talib said to him, I'm referring to the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the woman can give him, she can give birth in 6 months. Allah mentions that. And that child is normal. And it doesn't necessitate that this child is from somebody else. It can be from the father himself. He said, how? Where? Which ayah are you referring to? He said to him, okay, come. So Allah said in the Quran, وَوَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَوَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he talks to the children towards their parents and reminds them of the responsibilities of their parents and how you should be dutiful towards them. In that ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ 30 شَهْرًا The carrying of the child and the breastfeeding, Allah mentions, is 30 days, 30 months. 30 months is breastfeeding and also the pregnancy. We know in through the Quran in Suratul Luqman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَوَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ The pregnancy is for 2 years. Surah Al-Baqarah. 2 years. The breastfeeding is for 2 years. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَالْوَالِدَاتِ يُرْضِعْنَ أَوْلَادَهُنَّ حَوْلَيْنِ كَامِلَيْنِ 2 years. 30 months. How many months is 2 years? 24. Take away 24 from 30. So if Allah said that the breastfeeding and the pregnancy is 30 months, then 24 is the breastfeeding. So what's the 6 months left going to be? The pregnancy. It's going to be that? It's going to be the pregnancy. Ali ibn Abi Talib saw this. Who did Ibn al-Qayyim, sorry, did Uthman radiallahu anhu see this? Uthman didn't see this. وصاح. He's the man, Abdurrahman ibn Habib said, Abu Abdurrahman al-Sulami, the hadith that we all know. خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه Who narrated a hadith from the Prophet? Man is the one who narrated this hadith. Man is from القراء الكبار from the Sahabas. لذلك الكتاب معرفة القراء الكبار by Imam al-Dhahabi, he started with Uthman ibn Affan. He didn't mention Abu Bakr, now Umar. The first Qari in this Ummah that he wrote is who? Uthman, Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله تعالى. But that shows you, my brothers, what does that show you? Al-ihatatu lillah. To encompass everything. To know everything like that from all corners. It's for who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the only one who encompasses everything in knowledge. And this, my brothers, was dalalatul iqtida' is to bring the ayat together and to use it like that. This shows you that the sahabas, they knew usul al-fiqh. And they knew this science. When they needed it, they came out with it. Later it became a science, it's applied, it's done elsewhere, it's applied on other issues. And Ibn Shaykh Muhammad ibn Shanqita rahimahullah in his kitab, he goes in details in it. Ala kulli hal, my brothers, the khulasa of today's session, inshallah ta'ala, is that since Ramadan has finished and it's over, we should not make it, inshallah ta'ala, something that we stop what we were doing. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He allowed us to reach this great noble month and to benefit from it, let's be from those who, inshallah ta'ala, carry on the hard work, nurture our hearts, increase ourselves in knowledge and understanding. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.